The second straight week, the Jets could have won a game, but self-inflicted wounds just killed them. What were your impressions?
Okay, exactly. To be honest with you, I'm not sure if I should be discouraged or disgusted. I know it begins with D. This was frustrating. I thought the Jets were going to win this football game. If just come out and do what they do, run the football, control the clock, they spotted them 14 points. I did not like the opening play where they faked the screen and then came back for the screen the other way. As Geno pivoted, he lost completely any vision of the defense, and he turned and threw the ball right into the defense. So I'm sure that during practice, there was no one there, and that was completed. But that was a mistake, and that really didn't look good. And then all of a sudden you turn around. You know, they've got 7 points. They had a punt block on. I thought they were going to block the punt, but they didn't. And Jalen Sanders, you have to know as a punt returner, when you've got a block on, you've given up some of your protection, so you don't have their gunners doubled. And just fair catch the ball. And he reaches out for it. Well, now it's another turnover. Now, Nick, now you're looking at 14-0. And this type of thing was really discouraging. To start the game, Chicago, half the time they only had 3 receivers out. They couldn't run the football, and they weren't going to run it. I've never seen an offense substitute more offensive linemen into the game and line them up in eligible receiver positions. And it was all to pass block. There were times when they only had 1 receiver out to a side, but they knew if they could match up one-on-one against the Jets that they had a great chance in beating the Jets' corners when they did that. And that was a shame, because when they couldn't get to them with the blitz, when the Jets couldn't get to them, the Bears kept that extra guy in, and then they're able to make the plays with those great receivers. And that is frustrating. The red zone was really discouraging. I thought that they would become more productive in the red zone, and they just didn't get it done. I don't see the ball being thrown down the field in the red zone, and that's a little frustrating for me. You know, Amaro missed a ball that he should have had, which was a little frustrating, but he did make one nice catch. I think they have to retool that whole package. But Geno, I see some pressure. I'm disappointed, because I really had seen some development and moving forward. I like the way he was moving forward. I think he regressed tonight. I saw steps backwards. And I'm sure you saw the same thing. We saw some of the very same plays that we used to see. Don't forget, they dropped an interception right at their hands at the end of the game. That would have put the game long away before it happened. So I think if this persists, I'm not saying to take a look at Michael Vick right now, but trust me, he's in the back of my mind. He's very much in the back, and he's moving more forward as time goes on. So these are some discouraging things that take place in games that you could win. The Jets are good enough to win these football games, and to not win them, doggone, it's very discouraging, really discouraging for me.
Any positives you could take out of this game?
Well, sure, there's so many good things. Where the Jets are strong, they're strong. I questioned pulling away from Ivory a little bit. I thought he was running the ball like a freight train. I'm not quite sure. You know, all of a sudden I saw Johnson more involved in there, and that was a little discouraging for me to see that. But you know where the Jets are strong. I thought they pass protected fairly well. They've done a pretty good job there. I expected that. The run game is good. In a controlled game, they would have pounded the Bears running the ball. And the defensive front and safeties of the Jets are outstanding. You can't run the ball against them. And it was really illustrated by what they did. As I said, I've never seen a team substitute offensive linemen in eligible positions to just pass protect. They played half the game with 3 receivers. But that's all they needed. That's all they needed. So, again, you know, the weaknesses where the Jets are weak are really, really catastrophic and hurting them, because where they're strong, the New York Jets are very strong at some areas, and they've got to shore these things up. And Geno's got to get back on track, or I'm not kidding. I think I have to take a look at another guy, and Michael Vick is coming to my mind.
All right, thanks, Coach. Very frustrated, Mike Westhoff. Brian, back to you.